Hi, all hard drives have a motor that runs on 12 volts. I want to run this hard drive motor with 20 volts. Then, with the help of an oscilloscope, let's see how to adjust the speed of the hard drive motor. To turn on the hard drive motor, we need a speed control and server test. It is very simple to set up the circuit. Get an old hard drive so we can do this test. I got some old hard drives. Inside this hard drive, there is a motor and several plates. An electronic board is also located under the hard drive. We only need a motor. We separate all the parts. This motor has four wires. One of the wires is common. We do not use a common wire. But how to find the common wire? In this motor, the common wire can be easily recognized. This is a common pin. We do not use this pin. We will connect the speed control to these three pins. But in other motors, how to identify the common wire? We put the multimeter in off mode. We measure the amount of resistance between the pins. The common pin has the lowest value with other pins. The pins with the highest value are connected to the speed control. In this hard drive, we will use these three pins. Well, the wires are specified for connecting to a speed control. Now, let's see how to connect the speed control. These three wires connected to the motor of the hard drive. These motors are brushless, that is, they do not have a brush. These two wires are connected to the battery. I use a power supply. According to the type of speed control, use the right battery so that the circuit is not damaged. Hard drive motors do not need high current. Therefore, a speed control with less current can be used. Here we have three wires that connect to the server test. It has a negative, positive voltage and a signal wire. The red wire has 5 volts to turn on the server test. This piece is a server test. We use it to control the motor speed. It has two input and output sections. We do not use the input. The output section has three separate pins, negative, positive, and signal pin. We connect the speed control to these three pins. Pay attention to the color of the wires. To see the signal in the oscilloscope, I use the signal and negative pins. Connect two wires and connect to the oscilloscope. We connect the clip to the ground and the probe to the signal wire. Well, the circuit is ready. I connect the voltage. Wait a few moments until the circuit is ready to start. Pay attention to the sound of preparation. By turning the volume, the motor speed changes. I increase the voltage. Up to 21 volts. I slow down. When the motor stops, we have to reduce the voltage to start the circuit again. About 18 volts. Now I turn on the oscilloscope to see the signal. You see the PWM signal. The frequency is 50 Hz. As the volume rotates, the duty cycle changes. The maximum amount of duty cycle is 10%. The lowest value that causes the motor to shut down is 5%. There is a button on the server test. It has three working modes. The first mode is manual. The second mode is natural. The third mode is auto mode. In manual mode, we can adjust the speed. This is done by changing the duty cycle. In the second mode, the motor speed is constant with the duty cycle of 7.5%. In the third mode, the duty cycle fluctuates between 5 and 10%. The last two modes are for use in servo motors. You can change the side wires to change the direction of rotation. Now, in your opinion, did 20 volts really enter the motor? No, this is a PWM circuit. PWM is a voltage control method that determines the motor voltage according to the duty cycle. Therefore, 20 volts will never enter the motor. Now, use this motor and its speed setting for whatever you like. If you like this video, please like the video and write your opinion in the comments. Thank you for watching the video.